heart is open and the thump is going round and round. I got to put you down.
I got to put you down.
Ain't I talking to you, baby?
Yes, yes.
And I don't mean maybe.
Yes, yes.
You broke my heart from the start, now you know I'm bound. I got to put you down. I loved you truly the day you went away. I love you truly, but now my dear, it's all I say. Ain't I giving you all my love? Now ain't you my little friend now? Then either prove it or remove it, cause I'm going to town. I've got to put you down. But now, my dear, that's all passing. Can either prove it or remove it, cause I'm going to town. I got to put you down. I got to put you down. We got to put you down. I got to put you down. We got to put you down. Then either prove it or remove it, cause we're going to town. I gotta put you down!
Just what were you talking about,
ink or individual?
Oh, the audience, of course. You know what I mean, Uncle Ned.
Yep. Well, tell a green man something.
This show business is your whole life, isn't it, Uncle Ned?
Not this kind of show business, Ned. You know, I want to act in drama. Shakespeare, that's my ambition.
You've been saying that a long time. Why don't you do something about it?
Oh, you're a law student, Ned. You don't understand.
I understand enough to know you could realize your ambition.
They won't give me a chance, Ned. They keep saying, go on back to your cork and your comedy. Public's not ready for that dramatic stuff.
Well, maybe they're not, Uncle.
Ah, horse feathers, Ned. The public's ready for anything that's worthwhile and original. And someday, I'm going to do Shakespeare's Othello or my name.
Ah, who is it?
Oh, come right on in, Dollar.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's all right, come on in.
What's the matter?
Yeah.
I don't like to impose on your good nature, but would you mind running over that new business meet?
Well, no, of course not, honey.
Hello, Miss Avery.
Glad to see you, Miss Davis. You two go right ahead. I'm going up front.
See you later, Ned. Good luck. We need it. Now listen, Dow. When we walk out to the middle of the stage, I'm going to say to you, you're a pretty funny young lady. You take the call. What do you say?
No, you take the call, and I'll take the box.
That'll get it.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we have a guest with us tonight, a star of a decade ago. And you can believe me, she is marvelous as a singer of the blues. Ladies and gentlemen, she is the first of the Red Hot Mamas. I'd like to have you meet all over again, Mamie Smith. What do you say, huh? Mamie Smith.
No. Why don't you answer the phone?
Okay.
Matt? Oh, hello, Chief. Yeah, this is Janaway. What's that? He's in town? Okay, I'll tell Matt right away.
What's up?
Then Jewett's in town. You know what that means.
Stick on your pins. I'll be right back.
Yourself tonight, and someday when I get me a real show, you're gonna get a good part.
You've been mighty nice to me, Mr. Mann. You gave me my first real break in Harlem.
Yeah, Dom. I've helped a lot of them in show business in my time. But somehow or another, they won't let me do the one thing in life that I want to do most.
Well, someday you'll do that real show, Mr. Mann. You just keep punching.
Thanks, Dom.
Good night.
I will. Good night.
Got a match, buddy?
Yeah, sure. All right.
Listen, actor, you ain't seen nothing or heard nothing, see? Now blow.
That man. Oh, darling.
You love me, baby?
What do you think?
Listen, sugar, you know I'm a man of few words. Let's mug. Get up on the desk. Make yourself comfortable, babe.
It's all yours, Daddy.
I guess you like to worry over that now.
Well, what do you guys want?
Matt just knocked off Slim Jewett.
What? Yeah, and that actor Lem Anderson saw me turn the trick. Are you sure he saw who did it? He must have. Ruffians only 2 feet away.
You're a sap, Gilson. Right in a stage door where everybody could see you.
You're just gunning for.
What were you doing backstage,
Bob?
I know. You're trying to see Miguel down.
Oh, forget it, will you? What is that actor guy's for? We've got to bump him off, don't we?
Please don't let him do it, Ruff.
Shut up, doll.
We got to do something, Ruff.
Oh, we won't wait any longer. Let's knock him off. Don't get too ambitious, Ganaway.
Okay.
We'll do something about this, all right. But there'll be no more killing, and that's final.
Thanks, Ross.
Now listen, you mug. Here's what we're gonna do. Spanish, you and Ganaway get to that actor guy and tell him I say.
Thanks, Acme. You can go home now, honey. I'll take care of him.
Well, how's my little sweetheart tonight? How do you feel? Wait a minute. I'll get you something for that cough, honey. Here we are. Here's just what you need. Now, you take one of these and you're going to be all right. How do you feel, honey?
What's wrong, Lem?
Well, wrong? Well, there's nothing wrong, honey. What makes you think something's wrong?
I know. You're worried about me.
Oh, no, I'm not.
I reckon I won't be with you much longer, honey.
Oh, Emma, don't talk that way. You're gonna be all right, honey. You're gonna be all right.
But it's you I'm worried about. Why, Lem, your hand's shaking like a leaf. What's the matter, dear?
Well, I wonder who that could be at this hour. Be right back, dear.
You Lem Anderson?
Yes. What can I do for you?
Not what you can do for us, it's what you can do for yourself. You ain't seen nothing tonight. You ain't talking, and you're leaving town.
Leaving town? Who says so?
This. Is any album?
No, we make you dig a hole in the river.
Well, what do you mean?
You heard me. Breathe.
Come on, let's slip in more action. We're not here to argue, we're here to tell you.
Anna, but why should I leave town?
You
act sick. Don't start anything.
Yeah? Please. You'll be sicker than that if you don't get out of town.
Oh! I know. Emma. Emma! You wretch! You've killed my wife! You'll never get me to leave home! I'll see you hanged for it!
No? You don't want any more deaths in your family, do you? You got a nephew in Harlem you crazy about. You wouldn't want anything to happen to him, would you?
You wouldn't dare harm my nephew!
No? Well, the same thing will happen to him if you don't get out of town.
Emma.
Come on. Get out of town. I done told you. Get out.
Beat it.
Notorious gangster murdered. No trace of killer. Solid.
Get out of town.
What do you mean, get out of town?
Rough's orders. Get out of town.
You can't do this to me.
Again. You never acted like this since you moved in here.
All right. I got to get away. I got to leave town.
Well, what about all the plans you had for a sell-off?
I got to forget all about that. I just got to leave town. That's the way it's got to be, Ned.
I know how you feel, huh? On Emma and everything. Say, Elk, why don't you go away? I'm sure it'll do you good. Go away, will you?
That's right, Ned.
Sure.
Maybe a trip out of town right now would be good. But for my health.
But where will you go?
Where will I go? Why, back down south where I came from, of course. Sure. Swanee River, here I come.
Killing my wife.
Killing? How long did you get?
2 weeks.
Hmm? Mr. Police, you got your gun with you?
Yeah.
Loan it to me a minute, will you, please? Thank you, Mr. Police. Thank you. Stop kicking that left leg. That shot got him. Thank you, Mr. Foley. Thank you very much. Excuse me.
Yeah, let me get these things on good, Jesse. You know, I don't want to get away. Get them on good.
I forgot to tell you. After 2 weeks, they're going to hang me.
What? Like, yeah, get me out of these things, Jeff. Yeah. Get me out of here.
Hey, you. What do you mean going out on my stage like that?
What's the matter now?
Why, you're drunk again. That's what's the matter. And you spoil the whole performance, so you're through.
I get my laughs, don't I?
Oh, scratch it. Just because she was a big shot up north. Well, you can't come down here and ruin my show. And you're setting a bad example for the whole troop. So get your things in breeze, brother.
What do you mean?
I mean, catch some air.
Well, don't I get a 2 week notice?
A note.
Yeah, note.
You ain't got no contract, have you?
You know I ain't got no contract.
Well, you ain't working here no more, so get your things and get out of here.
Wait. Now, wait a minute, Jordan. Just a minute. Hey, listen. I ain't been right since I lost my wife. I had...
Oh, nuts on your wife. It's you I'm talking about.
Wait a minute. That's wrong. Now, don't talk about my wife like that.
Oh, nuts on your wife. It's you the one that's messing.
I'm asking you...
Take your hands off of me, you dirty buzzard!
Told you not to talk about my wife like that, buddy.
Well, that finishes you down here. While I'm just thrown off to the socket, you'll never get another job. But it's crooked just the same.
You're telling me.
I was born wrong. At the wrong time. Friday 13th.
So what, Papa?
Well, that leaves me behind the head wrong.
Oh, Joe Lewis was born Friday the 13th, and he made the grade.
And how? Think I'll try them that hip block and get away.
Yeah. But they tell me that fight racket is a tough one.
No more harder than starving.
I guess you're right at that.
Say, listen here.
What?
Honey, I see. He's all packed up.
Don't make that weak so strong.
And don't you start putting on the rich with that lone 2 bits.
What do you mean?
Because it ain't why to last you long.
Money don't make me. I make money. So, brother, I'm still queen for a day. Why, you no good clown. I told you I'd bring you down. So now you listen to what I've got to say. You're gonna miss me when I'm gone away. You're gonna sigh and cry for me both night and day. Worry and strife will be written all over your face when you find out that another has definitely taken your place.
Listen, baby, I didn't miss my butter when my bread was dry.
Bread, right, you mean.
I didn't miss my pappy when he said goodbye.
So what?
I didn't miss the old days, baby, and I positively will not miss the new. So how? You figure I'll miss you.
Well, I could be wrong, but I bet you miss my cooking. That's what got you so fat.
I'm on a diet.
And I'm sober as a judge, so I can't be talking through my head. You're gonna miss my fine hugging and that good plenty kiss. And all those tender moments, Papa, that brought you so much sense.
I didn't miss my jaw. When they give me the gig.
No.
I didn't miss the king when he asked the king.
Since when did you become a son?
I didn't miss the old deal, and I positively would not miss the new.
So,
honey, how you figure I'll miss you?
Well, I know that you remember when you were jiving too young for rats.
Oh, yeah, I
remember that. What's sauce for the goose is ketchup for the gander. You
listen, honey. I didn't miss my first wife.
The one that died in the wreck.
Again?
I didn't miss the investigator and that rascal.
Stand up my shake.
I didn't miss the WPA.
Well, your eyes on that, too. Let's break
so
your mind.
So, my eyes, you ever figure that I'm quite a million. Look,
Rapper, that's me on after the piano. Just go over there and ask him about that job, yeah?
All right.
Sure is.
Hello there, Steve.
What are you going to say, LeJoy?
Hey, yeah. I hear that you done dined up with that show that's wine up and off.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't love John and Winter. See, we get through here at the theater tonight.
Well, sure. Go see the man.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, but wait a minute. If you're going to talk to the man about a job, I'm going to do the talking. Because he's going to come up here using all them highfalutin words, and we ain't going to never get no job.
Why, boy, I am really surprised at your vocabulary.
Now, you see that? That's a word that ain't never been in the dictionary.
I'm so sorry that my language is a bit too high for the common element. Perhaps I should drop a dominion law where he could grasp my meaning. Now, after those few remarks have subsided, I shall proceed further into the proceedings. You don't know what I'm talking about, but I'm going to say it again. Now, after those few remarks have subsided, I shall proceed further into the pro...
Uh-huh. I'm glad it choked you.
Well, I said it the first time.
Well, you didn't say it right that time.
Right.
Oh,
go ahead.
Well, I said it too.
Oh, shut up.
Hey, big boy. Ain't you going to buy nothing? Hey.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Go ahead,
come on and get up out of
there. Cook, Steve. Ain't that an
animal? Sure. What's he doing here? What's the matter with him, Rocky?
I come in here and run out of dough.
Why, we know him. He was one of the biggest men in show business once.
So what? That ain't paying for my grog.
How much you owe you?
Oh, gas meter for this.
Give him 2 bits, Laura. I'll see what I can do for Lim. I'll pay you there. Come on, then, wake up. Wake up. Wake up. And you're high as a Georgia pine.
Don't you know who we are?
Hello, Steve.
Oh. What are you doing in this juke joint?
Just quit Jordan's show.
Yeah, we heard about it.
Yeah, Jordan put up an awful squawk. I guess you're through in the South.
I had this morning. Do you know what... Oh. But here.
Yes, you're in a pretty bad shape.
Thanks for looking after me.
Oh, that's all right. You were pretty swell to me and my first old lady when we were trooping in the South together.
I certainly wish you would stop bringing your first old lady into my life.
We quit that show that you was in with us, and we're now working our way back to New York.
You want to join us?
You want a man to play Uncle Tom? You can play him, can't you?
I've been playing Uncle Tom all my life. I don't want to play Uncle Tom. Shakespeare. That's what I'm gonna play. Shakespeare. Tell me, Walker. I'm gonna play Shakespeare. That's what I'm gonna play. Shakespeare.
Better stick to the thing you know best and leave the other fella racket alone.
Well, you know what a hard head makes.
Put some meat on there and it'll muffle it.
All right. Muffle it.
Well. Oh. Look out for my feet, will you?
Oh, man, what's the matter with you?
You know one thing,
Osler? This ain't right.
What ain't right?
Slipping out on Miss Mamie like this.
We owe that woman 4 weeks rent, don't we?
Yeah, but you can't get blood out of a turnip.
But you can put old turnip in jail. Well, go ahead and move it. Watch out for my feet, too.
Oh, man, I've been moving all the time.
My feet are... Watch out for them feet. Get your feet out of
here. Well, where y'all think you're going with them food sacks?
We ain't going nowhere. We just coming in.
Yeah. You sure you're lying?
Yes, ma'am. I know.
listen here.
Yeah.
I used to be a show woman myself. I knows what you're up against. Now y'all go right back upstairs to your room and don't be late for dinner.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Get along.
Now, wait, you come on, go first.
Now. Get along.
You ain't gonna step on my foot, no more.
Just go right on upstairs.
We'll be back for dinner. Don't worry about that.
Right.
We'll be back for dinner.
You'll pay me someday. I hope.
Instead of the ham what am, this is the ham what inch.
Hello, Miss Mamie.
Oh, hello, Miss Avery.
How do you feel, all right?
Fine.
That's good.
Did you get my message?
Oh, yes, I did.
Yes?
I managed to talk to those people.
Oh, yes? Well, they're right inside. Come right on with me.
Thank you.
Comes Miss Mamie.
You're a nice
girl. That's why I'm so fond of you. Folks, this is Mr. Avery, Lem's nephew. I told him you had something to tell him.
Glad to know you.
How are you, folks?
Well, go right ahead. Don't mind me.
We know your Uncle Lim.
Oh, yes?
He's in a pretty bad fix down south.
He sure needs help.
Well, what's the trouble?
Well, we told him when we got to New York, we were going to stop here with Miss Mamie.
And he said, be sure and see the Jews all right.
Oh, that's nothing. He always did worry about me.
But he sure needs help something awful. We did what we could for him.
I know where you can find him. If you can get him back up here, maybe you can get started again.
I got an idea, Ned. Brother Moe's church wants to do a high-class play.
That's right. Perhaps they'd let him put on Othello.
That would be nice. I'll go see Brother Moe's tonight.
That's a great idea, Miss Mamie. And it would bring Uncle Lem back, too.
I sure would like to see him again.
I'll see you later.
All right.
Again, huh?
So you owe Miss Mamie some board bill, huh?
We won't go into that.
Have you, Miss Agnew?
I didn't.
Oh, quiet,
what's the matter with you? You know you're supposed to sleep in the corners, not just the center of the room.
Yeah, but I told Madam Mamie when I come in here that I was strictly a center man.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, look here, honey. What's that shining you got under your apron there?
Oh, that's my costume.
Costume?
Yes.
What you doing with that on?
Oh, I've been upstairs rehearsing.
Oh, you into your business?
No, but I want to.
Oh, you want to be? Now, ain't that a coincidence? You looking at somebody that can do you a lot of good in show business. I'm closer to the boss than 99 S 100. Well, I'll put you on Broadway next week.
Oh, my.
Yeah, but suppose you let us see what the costume look like.
Certainly.
Yeah. I mean, this is going to be a killer here. Ha! Yes, sir. You working now and don't know it. What do you dance, honey?
Oh, just a little
jitterbug. Jitterbug? Beat out a little rhythm there for us.
You bet I will.
Lay it down there, honey.
Why, Agnew. Oh! What are you doing?
Oh.
Put your clothes on and get busy around
here. Yes,
Miss
Mamie.
You know we're going to have bad sex.
That actor guy?
Ain't nobody else.
What is he doing in Harlem?
Belching to the law, maybe.
Well, well, Miss Bluefoot, I'm mighty glad to see you again.
Well, Mr. Anderson, how are you?
Well, I'm quite well for an old-timer. Tell me, what's all the news here in Harlem?
Oh, nothing. Everything is quiet.
Everything quiet, eh? Well, that's good to see, all right.
Well, where have you been?
I've been south, Miss Bluefoot.
For your health?
Yes, I guess it was for my health.
I think I'll sap him.
Wait a minute. You tail him. I'll get rough.
Jam up.
But you know one thing? It's really a pleasure to get back here in Harlem again. I love it.
Oh, it's a pleasure having you back.
I'm glad to be here. I'll take this paper.
I thank you.
Give my regards to your husband.
I'll do that.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
I think it's great that Uncle Lim's coming back to do old fellow. And I'm sure it'll be a great success.
And my church people agree that this production of Othello will make for better entertainment in the community.
And just think of it. It'll reach the man who never goes to church.
Exactly, Desdemona.
Won't Lim be happy acting in Othello and at the same time helping the cause?
All of my people are enthusiastic, and the spiritual uplift will be tremendous.
Gee, I wish they'd come. I'm so anxious to meet Ned's uncle.
Are you sure it's him they saw?
Dead sure. Gannaway's trailing him now.
Well, you get word of Gilson to show up my office as soon as he can.
Now listen, boss. You better watch Gilson. He never got over the fact that you snatched Doll Davis from him.
Don't you worry about Gilson. I'll take care of him. Here you are, son.
Thanks. Come on, Dad.
If Brother Anderson will faithfully work with us, this play will be to the everlasting credit of Harlem.
It'll be the dream of my life if he'll let me act with him. Oh, you'll act with him, all right.
Hello, folks. Is Lim here yet?
No, he hasn't come yet.
I hope he heard us. I'm ran to go. Hello.
Oh, yeah, where's that?
Now, sit down, brother. Sit down. Y'all make yourself comfortable.
Hello, folks.
While I
fix
some.
Hey, what's that? Hello, folks. Hello, what's that? We're down in that.
Listen, you know, we're all going to have a great show when Lim comes.
Come on, Unc. They're all waiting.
I wonder what's keeping him. Oh, here comes Lim now. Lim, and if you ain't the same person, you haven't changed a bit.
Doggone, Miss Mamie, you look younger than ever.
You think so? Did you have a fine trip?
Oh, Miss Mamie, I had a wonderful trip. We laid over in Washington for about a half an hour, but I was very impatient because I was in a hurry to get here to some of your good biscuits.
I knew they'd draw you.
There!
Yeah. This is my surprise. Yes. My fiancée, Miss Desdemona Jones, is going to play opposite you.
Hello, Uncle
Lim. Desdemona? Mm-hmm. Why, that's the name of one of the leading Shakespearean characters.
That's right.
Desdemona. Oh, you remind me so much of my Emma when we were married.
Thank you, sir.
You've made a fine choice, my boy, and I'm sure you're both going to be very happy.
Thanks, Uncle Lim.
Lim, I want to introduce you to Brother Bones.
Glad to know you, Brother Bones.
Glad to meet you, sir, but the name is Moan.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Come, let's sit down and have something to eat.
All right.
Now, I want you all to help me.
Yes, indeed. Look here, boy. Well, this is going to be good.
You mentioned me again.
Gee, he's lucky, huh?
That boy is lucky.
Must have a rabbit foot. Hi, boys.
Hi.
Now listen, you dudes, I told you no more killing. My picture's in the paper again. Any time anybody even runs too fast in Harlem, the cops come to me.
Well, suppose that ham act is cool.
Well, you gotta figure out a way to get rid of him easy. John?
We could get the nephew. I'll find out where he lives.
Maybe a hint to him might do some good, huh?
Yeah, we can convince him that we don't want his uncle around here.
All right, but take it easy.
Okay, Chief. See you later.
Audition and everything?
Why, sure. That's a good idea. Why not?
Well, what are you waiting on? There's a plenty of talent right here.
All right, let's get started then.
Let Miss Mamie start us off,
that's
huh?
It, that's
oh,
it.
Come on, Miss Mamie.
No, I can't.
Come on now. You sing that good old song.
I got
you. You know, you sound long down before they don't.
I can't sleep at night. I can't eat a bite. 'Cause the man I love, he don't treat me right. He makes me feel so blue. I don't know what to do. Sometimes I said his sigh and then began to cry. He went away and never even said goodbye. There's a change in the ocean, change in the deep blue sea. My baby, I'll tell the world there ain't no change in me. My love for that man will always be. Now I've got the Harlem blues since my man went away. I ain't got no time to lose. Yes, I must find him today. He makes me feel so blue. I'll do things I I'll do like the Chinaman Bay, calling hop, gonna stand on the corner, gonna blow my top. Since my love has been refused, now I've got the Harlem blues.
Harlem, Harlem, now she's got the Harlem blues. Yes, she's got it. Then the man is gone away.
Gone away.
She ain't got no time to lose. That dirty man has done her wrong.
Boom, 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 boom.
He left her feeling blue.
Boom, 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 boom.
Doing things that she wouldn't do. She's going down to the river, take a rope and a rod, tie it round her neck and jump over the dock. 'Cause her love has been refused. Now she's got the Harlem blues. Her brains is reeling. Now she's got the Harlem blues. A crazy feeling. Now she's got the Harlem blues.
Great, all right.
Well, I'm glad you liked it.
Sure, we liked it.
I was a little out of practice,
oh,
but the boys helped me out.
Oh, you don't make
just
it
like
more
time jumping
out of practice.
Let me tell you something. Well, I guess I must be going now. My deacons are anxious to hear of this meeting.
Well, good night, Brother Mones.
And you'll be ready to start your rehearsals immediately?
Immediately? Why, Brother Mones, I've been waiting for this opportunity longer than you have.
Well, good night, children.
Good night,
night,
Brother Mones.
Good
thank
night.
You very much.
All right,
Brother
Mones, you're a dear.
I'm happy about this myself, my child. Good night, children.
Good night,
good night.
Good night, Brother Mone.
Well, we must be off, too. I promised to get Desdemona home early.
Well, good night, children.
Good night.
See you in the morning.
Good night.
See you
later.
Good night, Dad. Good night, Desdemona. And,
Miss Mamie.
Yes?
Take care about the lamb now.
Don't worry about that. I'm not going to let him out of my sight.
I know that.
Miss Mamie, you're a knockout, I swear. Just like you always been.
Hello, chick. What's this joker trying to do? Give you a good time?
Yeah, maybe you need some help. That'll be enough out of you.
Bessie, well, you saw mauled for a dame with a name like that.
Why?
You'll be all right, my boy.
I hope so.
You know, Ned, you were pretty lucky. If this came down a half inch more, we'd have had trouble with your sight. I tell you what you do, Ned. Drop into my office and say a day or two. I want to check and see that that heel fits.
Okay, Dad.
I want to bid you people good night.
Good night, Dad.
Good night, Dad.
Thanks very much.
Good night. Thank you for calling.
Good night.
feeling, Ned.
Okay, honey. Well, I wouldn't worry so much about it. Dr. Reverend said it wasn't serious.
No, it was dreadful. Why, he might have been killed.
And you're sure you don't know who did it, Ned?
No, I don't know.
Oh, they said something about making you remember, Uncle Lim.
Hoodlum, they ain't got no respect for nobody. Come, Desdemona. I'll take you home.
Are you sure you'll be all right, dear?
Oh, he'll be all right, child.
Absolutely. Don't worry, honey.
All right, then. I'll be around in the morning, yeah?
Okay, sweetie.
Bye.
Bye-bye, honey.
Take care of yourself, Ned. Night.
Oh, you'll be all right.
Don't worry about me. I'll be all right.
Ned?
Yes, Uncle Lim.
There's something I've got to tell you.
Yeah?
Do you remember that Slim Jewett killing some time ago?
Slim Jewett?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, yes, the gangster who was killed in front of the stage door.
Well, Ned, I saw that murder.
You did?
Yeah.
But why didn't you notify the police?
Oh, that's just it. I couldn't.
What do you mean you couldn't, Uncle?
Well, after the killing, I went home. Emma, she was terribly sick. Two men came to the house and told me if I didn't get out of town, you'd get the same as Slim Jewett.
Oh, this doesn't make sense.
Oh, the whole thing don't make sense.
What did they do to me?
Look what they did to you tonight, Ned.
You mean?
That's it. You see, Ned, I didn't want to spoil your career, so I thought I'd better go away again.
If I'd only known.
I made a mess of it, and I think I'd better go away again, Ned.
Oh, no, you don't. You'll not sacrifice yourself for me again.
But what else is there to do?
You're staying right here and concentrating on Othello. We'll handle it somehow.
Solid boy.
Here to help you out tonight.
Yeah. Yeah. You ever do any valet work?
I'm the valet, this valet that ever valeted.
Yeah, I'm gonna take you up on that. And that's one thing. If you don't know what you're doing, you better ask somebody.
Oh, I ain't got to ask nobody, but I still know what I'm doing.
Give me a little of that shampoo there,
that stuff. A little shampoo it shall be.
Hey, how's everybody down to Mamie's?
Everybody down to Mamie's is all right. The house is really jumping.
House won't jump long if somebody don't pay some rent, you know that.
Well, this here, folks, just between me and you now, you better let that doll Davis alone.
You know, there's only one thing about doll Davis. If she's jiving everybody around here, including you and me,
she ain't jiving me. Well, I am jive through.
Yeah, that's the
truth. That, boss, this stuff is burning.
Yes, it is burning. Hey, you better get around the edges quick.
Wait.
Let me get around the edges.
Get off my ear.
Wait,
I ain't got no back.
Well, you don't have to drop it down my back.
But hold on.
Now, a minute now.
You better get to the water. Let me get you right here.
Get to the water.
Never mind,
Ed.
Just get to the water.
Gone away.
What do you say, Spanish?
Okay, Chief.
Sit down, get yourself a drink.
Straight ride.
Make it double.
Well, what's a jive now?
That act is still hanging on.
Yeah, he's been rehearsing for a week with the church folks and our half-ride family.
I had my way. I put them in church and I barked. Did you say church people?
Yeah, that joker's got all the churches in Harlem behind him.
There's only one way to be safe, Chief. Rub him out.
Quiet down. Bad enough to have the cops down on us. If we get these church people down on us, we'd all have to blow town.
What are we going to do about him then?
Well, what do you say we get him in church? What do you say we get him in wrong? Throw some women in his lap. Get him drunk. These churches saw on him, he's gone goblin.
He's a pretty wise old Oscar. He wouldn't fall for it.
Yeah, he's not smart enough to duck the woman I'm gonna throw at him. There she is.
Hey, Pete.
Yes, Ruff.
Tell Dal Davis where I want her to come over here to the table.
Okay, Ruff.
I want Dal Davis to do this.
That's a chump. Dal's in my stable now. You get it?
Fair, Ralph. You and me supposed to be pals.
She ought to know who she wants by now, and I'm the head man.
Hello, fella. What do you want, Ralph?
What do you have to drink, baby?
Scotch and soda.
Hey, waiter. Get Miss Davis a scotch and soda. Listen, babe, I got a little job for you.
Yeah, but it's Ralph's idea, not mine.
I wouldn't expect you to have the idea.
Now, wait a minute, doll. This is me, Matt Gilson, remember? I take you to the first show. Give you 3 squares a day.
So what?
Cut it out quick. Listen, babe. You remember that actor guy, Len Anderson?
Yeah, whatever's become of him. He's okay.
He's putting on one of these here theatrical plays here in Harlem.
That's great. I wonder if he'd give me a job.
You're gonna work for him, baby.
Work for him?
Yeah.
What's on your mind?
Get him excited about you. Get him drunk. Anything. We'll do the rest.
Why couldn't he do it, Ralph? He thinks I'm a good kid.
Look, if these church people get sore against him, he'll have to leave town, and that'll be for his own good.
Well, I'll go and tell him to do that.
Sit down. You'll do it my way. Now, here's what happens. You invite him to your apartment. You get him drunk. You get me?
Oh, I couldn't do it, Ralph. You're asking too much.
I saved his life once for you. Now, do it again if you do as I say.
Well, folks, thanks to Brother Moans here, we've reached the stage of our first rehearsal. And as you all know, Othello was a Moor.
He was a what?
He was a Moor, a Moor.
What kind of man is that?
Well, you see, he was a general in the Venetian state.
Mr. Lamb.
Huh? He married Desdemona, Brabantio's daughter. And later on, his good friend Iago makes him believe that his wife Desdemona is unfaithful. And in Act 5, Scene 3, I think that's called the handkerchief scene, Othello, in a jealous rage, kills his wife.
Ain't that a shame?
But later on there, when he finds out that his wife is innocent, in a tremendous climax in the last act, Othello kills himself.
Then what?
And then Othello dies. That's the end of the play. Oh, Desdemona, just a moment, please. Now, in the handkerchief scene, Desdemona, you'll be stage right on a couch, asleep. I'll come in and I'll do my lines. I walk toward you.
Mr. Lamb!
What's the matter, honey?
We ain't never gonna get the show on.
Well, why not, Ackman?
Because Sam Jenkins is upstairs in the dressing room with a big bag of peanuts.
Can you imagine that? Peanuts.
Oh, Acme, honey, what's wrong with peanuts?
Backstage, peanuts are bad luck.
Why, the hardest lick I ever hit my voice so late it was for bringing peanuts into the dressing room.
Peanuts.
Look out, Ridley. You got me in your power again.
Is Mr. Lem Anderson here?
Does he know you?
Just say it's Dal Davis.
I'll see.
Miss Anderson, someone's there.
Oh, all right, Dewey. Relax, you all. I'll be back in a minute.
Oh, hello, Mr. Lamb. Remember me?
Do I remember Dal Davis? Why, sure I do.
I'm afraid I'm not doing so good.
Well, you look like you're doing all right, honey.
Well, you never can tell. I suppose you wonder why I'm here, don't you, Mr. Lamb? Well, I heard that you were doing a play. And you did say, if you ever did one, that you would give me a part, remember?
Oh, sure I did, doll.
I guess we better be going, too.
I think so. Excuse us, folks. Good night.
Good night, Brother Mo.
Good night.
Good night, y'all. Say, come on, y'all. Let's get the rehearsal started.
My Lord. My Lord. What ho, my Lord. Hey, Lem, where do you want me to die, upstage or down?
Them is too busy out there talking to that notorious Doll Davis.
Say, you know anything about Shakespeare?
Not a thing.
Well, neither do the rest of my cast, so we all start from scratch. Now, you sit right here, and I'll be right up in a minute, here.
Hey, what's she calling Lord's name so much for?
Don't ask me. You know much about this here play as I do.
Folks, I know you'll be glad to hear that I've just engaged another professional, Miss Doll Davis.
He's a leckerhead.
Well, so was I. Sneezed until I got another chance. She's all right.
Know too much.
Why, it's terrible bringing a cabaret girl in a church play.
You're right. She's a bad character and she'll ruin our show.
Oh, Lem Anderson must be losing his mind.
Nix, nix, nix. Jacob's mind.
Well, that'll be all for today, folks. No more rehearsal. Same time tomorrow.
Thanks.
Thank you. Right,
that's no good.
Good to meet you. Have some lovely weather, ain't you?
Mr. Lem, I don't think I'm going to be so popular around here.
Well, now, don't you worry about that, child.
Oh, don't worry about me. I'm going back to that liquor party where I just came from.
Oh, come on, doll. Snap out of it, honey. Don't you worry about anything anybody says. You're going to be in this show, and you're going to be good.
Well, Mr. Lem, why are you so good to me?
Come on, kid. I'll walk you home.
Yeah. There goes Lem with the doll now. You know what to do, Galloway.
Do something worthwhile here in Harlem. But what I wanted to say to you, doll, was that it's just a bit part. Do you think you like it?
Yeah, but I'm kind of afraid of Ruff. Ruff's gone soft. We got to take this matter ourselves, huh?
Why, you're not yourself. Do you mind if I see you upstairs?
Well, I'd be glad if you would, please, Mr.
Lem. I'd be glad to. Come on, we don't need to take it easy.
Listen, I'll furnish you the getaway, though, you understand? If the frail gets in your way, blast her, too. Now get going.
Okay. Well, doll, honey, you just lay down and take a little rest, and I'm sure that you're going to feel all right in the morning.
I hope so, Mr. Lem. I feel a little better already.
Uh-huh. Goodbye.
Oh, won't you come in just for a little while?
Well, just for a few minutes.
Just come on in, Mr. Lem, and make yourself at home.
Well, how do you feel, Dow? Don't you think you ought to lie down for a minute?
No, I feel much better. Let me take your coat.
Oh, thanks, thanks.
Just sit right in that big easy chair over there. You'll what? Find all the theatrical papers right there.
Uh-huh, the variety.
You know, Mr. Lem,
huh?
I'll never be able to thank you for that part you gave me.
Oh, that's all right, Dow. You just made good. That's all I want.
Won't you have a little drink?
Uh-uh, Dow. That's done enough damage to me already.
Well, I'll have one.
Uh-oh. You better lay off, too.
Well, I guess you're right.
Sure.
Oh, Mr. Lem.
Yep.
Do you feel like rehearsing that part with me again?
Well, sure, I don't mind.
Well, I'll tell you what you do. Just sit there, just a minute. And here's my scrapbook. Here's all fine. The pictures while I make myself comfortable.
Oh.
You'll find it very amusing.
Fine, thanks.
Say, doll, you've done some nice things according to this scrapbook.
Thank you, Mr. Lem.
Doll, I'm certainly going to help your career.
He won't
stay away. Oh, I can't go. Who is it?
I'll get it, Dal.
Get on in there, sir. And Don't make no bad move.
What's the idea? Why don't you leave me alone?
You got it coming, chump.
I'm minding my own business. Haven't you done enough for me already? You killed my wife and you ran me out of town?
We told you to stay out. Now we ain't got no more patience. Say your prayers, actor.
Cut it out, Galloway. You know what Ruff said. No shooting, no killing.
Be quiet, chick, or I'll kick your teeth down your throat.
Ben.
The heck with what Ruff said.
Dog. Get away quick, Mr. Lamb. They'll blame you. Gilson and Ruff. Watch out. Get a doctor.
Thank you, Miss Mamie. Thank you. Now, will you give me the potatoes, please?
Boy, you don't think Dave me no potatoes up here.
Well, what is that?
They think, give me them potatoes. They don't even say the blessing up here like they do down home.
No?
No. They just say good bread, good meat. Thank the president and go ahead and eat.
You're such uneducated person. Such colossal stupidity. Why, boy, you is absolutely illiterate. You is absolutely illiterate.
You gonna run into my razor yet?
Now, stop that now, stop that now.
You all right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Good, ma'am.
Have
enough? Yes, ma'am. How you
murder my nephew. And now they try to shoot a girl that's going to defend me. Yeah. Well, they want me out of Harlem. By God, let them run me out. That's what he can do.
What's the matter? Oh, wait, 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 wait,
wait. Ladies and gentlemen, we sincerely hope that you've enjoyed our show up till now. And fine, fine, fine. And what do you think? And now, ladies and gentlemen, for a wee portion of a Broadway atmosphere. And who do you think is going to give it to you? None other than an inimitable singer of songs, Laura Lou. All right, here she is.
Love to me is a strange affair. It leads you here and it leads you there. Why should I wonder where it will all end? Why do I wonder if we can be friends? Oh, maybe I'm right, maybe I'm wrong. Sometimes it seems that we will never get along. Sweetheart mine, my I gave you my love, gave you my all. been before, I can't say I'm always content. When I'm with you, someday you'll love just the way I want you to. If you love me as I love you, then why have you made me so blue? Darling, why have you made me blue?
I got my alibi. Say, you. The guy named Anderson coming here?
I don't know, but there's a truck over there.
Oh, trouble. Come on.
Hey, you Ruff Jackson?
Yes, I'm Ruff Jackson.
Well, why don't you let me...
Hey, some question about Doc Davis. Come on.
Although pronounced out of danger, Miss Davis is unable to supply the slightest clue to the police. And the producer, Lem Anderson, last seen with Miss Davis, is held for questioning.
Poor Lem. He never seems to get out of trouble. The show opens tonight, and he's in jail.
Imagine my embarrassment. And if it hadn't been for such a tremendous sale of tickets, my people would wipe their hands of the whole affair.
The district attorney has agreed.
Under certain conditions. He will deliver Lem to the theater tonight on the police car.
You mean to say a policeman is going to be with him?
Exactly. And after the performance, Lem must return to headquarters.
You know we got to clear Lem of his whole mess.
Doubt. You see, Lem is too stubborn to talk. And the girl, she won't talk. So there isn't anything further I can do.
But I can. I'll go to the hospital, and I'll have a talk with that girl.
Lem. Oh, my head. Rob, Galloway.
Okay for visiting?
Yes, Bennett.
It's all right.
Oh, my head. Are you all right, Mr. Lem?
Yes, Mr. Lem is all right.
They didn't shoot him, did they?
No, he's alive. He ain't hurt none. He's only anxious about you.
He's so fine and so good. And what they try to do to him.
If you really want to help Mr. Lem, you'll tell me what happened.
Who are you?
Just a friend of yours, just like you.
They try to frame him, the mob. They try to run him out of town. They try to ruin him with the church people, disgrace him. I took him to my apartment. He wasn't to blame. I just couldn't go through with it. He's always been so nice to me.
And then what happened?
I tried to stop Gannaway from shooting. I tried to save Mr. Lem. Oh, do you think I'm going to die?
No, child. You're not going to die. The doctor says you're going to be all right. Who tried to run him out of town?
Ralph Jackson and Matt Gilson, that's why.
Yes.
Mr. Lamb saw Gilson shoot Jewett.
Yes.
They were afraid.
Yes. Honey, child, you don't know what this means to Lamb Anderson and to me. Oh, you
It ain't no need to cry, little girl, because a lot of things happen in show business.
Yeah, you're going to cry about this. Our star's in jail, and he ain't going to get out. So you might as well take off your costume.
Why? There's Uncle Lem now.
Where?
All right, Anderson. Go on with your show, but remember, I'll be here with to take you back with me.
Wait. I'll go see.
I understand.
Glad to see you, Uncle Lem. The folks are waiting. Ready to go on?
Sure.
What are you waiting for? Get in the costume and the makeup and everything.
Hello, pal. Waiting for someone?
Yes, I'm from headquarters. I'm waiting for Anderson.
I can find this out.
Jack Adams. He told me. He was visiting the Gannaway before he left town.
Oh, that's it, huh? Gannaway shoots Dove trying to get Anderson. There's only one guy in town could have given orders for that.
Sure. Matt Gilson.
Yeah. That's it. Matt Gilson, the lousy double-crossing rat. Just a case.
Where are you going, boss?
I'm going where I know I'll find Gilson.
It is the cause. It is the cause, my soul. Yep, she must die or she'll betray more men. Peace.
It's wonderful.
Put out the light and then put out the light.
Yeah, go ahead and put out the light so we can all go to sleep.
I cannot give it vital growth. It must needs wither.
Get away from there.
Ah, she waits.
Oh, fellow. Won't you come to bed, my lord?
Nothing to himself, Simona. Here it is.
Heaven have mercy on you.
Desdemona, with all my heart. Amen.
Some bloody passion takes thy very fame. I hope it do not point to me.
Desdemona. That handkerchief that I so loved and gave to thee, thou gavest Cassio.
No, no, my life, my love, my soul.
Sweet soul, take heed, thou art on thy deathbed.
My lord. not to die, not yet to die. Yes, yes, tell him Desdemona.
To deny each article of oath and not remove or choke the strong connection that I grow with all. Thou art to die.
No, no, she shan't die. No, no, she shan't die. No, no, she shan't die. She shan't die, no, she shan't die.
Well, there's your Othello.
Solid
boy.
Uncle, you have you have
well, then, get your clothes on. Everything's going to be all right. Thank you very
much. And you were all fine in your part, each and every one of you.
You were the one, Uncle.
Ah, but Desdemona, I owe a lot to your work.
Still it.
It wasn't exactly the Othello that I wanted
to do. Huh? It might not have been the Othello you planned, but you sure.
they don't like it. Oh, yeah. Oh, honey.
Oh, they're so afraid of me. Maybe I am.
Still looking for Len Anderson, eh?
Yeah, and I'm gonna get you too.
Lousy elf, Master. You're a bad loser, Gilson.
Folks, and the best news of all is this. I have an offer to go to Broadway with Othello, a jazz band, and a choir.
Oh, no!
Uh-huh.
Why?
Yes, indeed, a choir.
Baby,